दोस्तों, इस क्लास में आपको डिक्टेशन दूंगा मैं 100 WPM पर। 600 वर्ड्स की डिक्टेशन है, आपको डिक्टेशन में प्रोवाइड कर रहा हूँ। बी रेडी फॉर इट। द प्रोविजन फॉर रिहैबिलिटेशन एंड रीइंटीग्रेशन सर्विसेज हैज़ सेवरल फेसेट्स एंड कैन नॉट बी रीड इन आइसोलेशन बट मस्ट बी रीड इंटर आलिया इन कंजंक्शन विथ Section 54 of the JJ Act, which requires the inspection of child care institutions registered under the said Act. Inspection committees are required to be set up, which shall mandatorily visit all facilities housing children in the area allocated at least once in 3 months in a team of not less than 3 members, of whom at least one shall be a woman and one shall be a medical officer. Their inspection reports are required to be furnished to the district child protection unit or the state government as the case may be for further action. Form 46 of the model rules prepared under Rule 41 thereof is quite exhaustive, and if the form is filled up with due seriousness, it will go a long way in improving the living conditions of children in child care institutions. The importance of rehabilitation and social reintegration clearly stands out if we appreciate the objective of the JJ Act, which is to foster restorative justice. There cannot be any meaningful rehabilitation, particularly of a child in conflict with law, who is also a child in need of care and protection, unless the basic elements and principles of restorative justice are recognized and practiced. Unfortunately, one of the problems faced in introducing restorative justice is that a child in a child care institution is treated as a number, and no effort is made to introduce any individual child care plan postulated by Rule 19 of the Model Rules, read with Form 7. Learned amicus informed us that the form is very rarely filled up and little or no attention is paid to the needs of each child, including a child in conflict with law. She submitted that specific directions should be given for the preparation of individual child care plans in every child care institution, since that is really the heart of rehabilitation and social reintegration of a child in need of care and protection. Of course, some expertise is involved in this exercise, but as we had mentioned earlier, there is no shortage of manpower in our country, and it is only the will of the state governments, union territories, and the union government which is coming in the way of the effective implementation of the provisions of the JJ Act, model rules, and filling up various forms and their analysis. One of the more important issues raised by the learned amicus in the context of rehabilitation and social reintegration is to be found in Rule 89. Of the model rules, which concerns itself with training of personnel dealing with children. This rule provides for a minimum period of 15 days training to various categories of personnel under the JJ Act, including the staff of children's courts, principal magistrates, and members of juvenile justice boards, chairpersons and members of child welfare committees, police officers, including persons in charge of child care institutions, etc. It has been brought to our notice in cases of adoption of children, some extremely unusual and impracticable orders have been passed by the concerned courts. It is high time that the high courts exercise their supervisory jurisdiction and intervene and take appropriate remedial steps. It is also high time that training of personnel be given due importance. We may note here that it was brought to our attention by the learned amicus that untrained or inadequately trained personnel can unwittingly play havoc with the lives of victims of sexual abuse or sexual assault or sexual harassment. दोस्तों इसी के साथ ये डिक्टेशन फिनिश होती है. उम्मीद है आप लोगों ने इसे अच्छे से लिखा होगा. लगातार प्रैक्टिस करते रहिए. इसकी 120 WPM की डिक्टेशन ऑलरेडी प्रोवाइड की जा चुकी है, जो कि एक पेड कोर्स है. अगर आप उन डिक्टेशंस को भी लिखना चाहते हैं तो आप कोर्स को परचेज कर सकते हैं. आपसे मुलाकात करूँगा मैं अगली क्लास में अगले ट्रांसक्रिप्शन के साथ. तब तक के लिए बाय बाय, टेक केयर.